Jordan!
So, you know, until that time, I took everything he's earned until then. Robert Garcia said that he's picked against you before and he's been wrong.
Yeah.
He's like, I'll probably pick Crawford, but yeah. I could be wrong.
He's not mad at him.
What do you think about that?
It's a lot of people who have known Terrence and I both for a long time. I just ran into Coach Bashir Abdullah. He was a 2004 Olympic coach, 2008 Olympic coach. I've been to Brazil with Coach Abdullah. I've been to Venezuela. I've been all around the world with Coach. And I said, Coach, I know you've coached both of us as amateurs. He said, yeah. I said, but the best part about it, man, is it's a great fight for boxing. And he said, yeah, man. He said, I can't wait for it and I'll be there. You know, so it doesn't matter if you pick me, if you pick him. Obviously, we both got to go in the ring and do our thing. But more than anything, man, I just want I'm going to put on a show that's going to be memorable for a long time.
Sean,
I think even if you picked against me before, you didn't forget that I was in the ring.
Terrence Crawford says he's excited to beat one of the PBC guys. You're friends with him. We respect Crawford because he's a great fighter. We respect you. What do you think? What do you answer him when he says he's coming to beat a PBC guy?
You know, he's saying what he's supposed to say. You know what I mean? Just like I won't answer a question about strategy. I won't answer a question about what he does well, what he does bad. You know, it depends on what I say. You know what I mean? So he can say he's looking forward to beating a PBC fighter. He can say he's looking forward to getting in the ring with a PBC fighter. But we both know I'm not the PBC fighter he wanted to get in the ring with. And that's not even talking about Errol Spence Jr. So there's that.
We know you've been after this fight for
hold
a few
on,
years.
I got him first.
You think
it better be good, too. Better be good.
You think Terrence Crawford would be your biggest test of your career?
I really do. I think that this is the best fight for me right now. I think to date, it's the best fight for me to date. I think that he's going to present some things in the ring that nobody else has, and vice versa, which is what makes it such a good fight.
How will you beat him?
All right, so you've been after this fight for a few years now, Shawn. We know that, right?
Yeah, a little bit.
Now that you became the mandatory, how excited were you when you found out that this fight was actually going to go to purse bid and that you actually had a shot?
When I saw someone text and told me about the tweet that WBO did, I just sat back. I was actually at a hotel room at that point in time. I sat back. I said, man, I love the WBO. You know, they kind of, in some ways, they've made my dream come true. You know what I mean? I think that once I got in the ring with Errol Spence Jr., we didn't get that decision, but it was a great night. It was like, okay, who can I have another great night against that I haven't already had a great night with? And, you know, everybody wants rematches. Everybody loves to see rematches, but I'm all about what's next and what's best. And to me, Terrence Crawford in 2019, he was next, and he was what was best. And still that way now at 2021.
Shawn, what's the reaction you've gotten from peers just since the fight's announced?
Everybody's excited about it, man. Boxers are excited about this, you know what I mean? I got a lot of people hitting me up like, hey, let me help you on camp, so on and so forth. So, man, I'm in a blessed position. And y'all know I always come ready, but you know, I'm definitely going to be always putting that work in and doing what I need to do. So I can be 100%. It's like I always say, I only got to be 100% one time, and that's on fight night.
I got an analyst question for you.
What is kind of, thank you. That's how I want it.
What kind of strategy does he have to come into for
this? Oh, man. To me, it's a winnable fight for Caleb Plant. And that's even taking my bias out of it. I think that he has the ability to box, to use the ring, to use his speed and his quickness, much more intelligent and much more tougher than a lot of people know about him. I know that personally about him. So when I consider those things, I say, yo, it's possible for him to win that fight. But again, he's got to be damn near 100% to pull it off against Canelo Alvarez.
How you say you know he's tough? You sparred or something?
Oh, we've been
like
in the ring before. I don't know, 2014, 2015, maybe somewhere along the way.
Sean.
And I've been around him enough to know him.
My last question. In the amateurs, you beat Usyk.
Yeah.
He's not fighting Joshua. Any advice for him for the fight with Joshua?
No advice. You know, if anything, I would say do what got you there. But even beyond that, man, we didn't see everything, or I didn't see enough of him in his previous fight. I didn't see the power. You know,
so he has power.
But I didn't see it in his last fight. So he's got to have power if he's gonna beat Joshua. So he's got the boxing ability, movement, all that, speed, agility, intelligence, all that. But he's got to be able to have some thump. against Joshua.
Are you going to watch a fight?
Congrats, Sean. Thank you, man. Congrats.
To my nephew, right. Gus. Say, hey, this is a world champion, Sean Porter. I want to give a shout out to Gus.
What's up, Gus? Showtime Sean Porter here, man. God bless you. Take care.
Congrats. Thank you, Sean.
Thank you, Sean. Thank you.
What's up? I've been rocking with you for a week.
Jordan.
Blew up on Twitter.
How are you?
Hey,
come on, let's do it.
I got you.
All right. I'll see you tomorrow.
Yes.